So if you wanted to create a visual effect, like an explosion, how would you make that effect appear between the subject that's being filmed in a physical space and the background of that physical space?
So to achieve this effect, the first thing we're going to need to do, because we haven't filmed with a green screen, is we're going to need to cut the outline of me out of the background, right? And that effect is called rotoscoping. So not so long ago, doing rotoscoping is actually pretty hard work, and you need to know what you're doing with platforms like After Effects or equivalent. Nowadays, there is some AI platform out there which you or I can use, and they're dead simple. And the one that I'm going to show you today is something called runwayml.com. And there's a link to this in the description below. This is what it looks like when you first go on to RunwayML. There are loads of things you can actually do on this platform, but what I'm going to use it for is to do edit videos. Okay, and I'm going to click on remove background. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to upload the original video intro to camera of me, and I'm going to click on upload. Here we go. Visual effects intro edit is the name of the file. And it just takes a few minutes to upload. Now it's uploaded, I'm just going to select that file and drop it onto the timeline. And after a moment or two, there it is, there's the original intro. So I basically click on what I want to start masking, and that will indicate what I'm keeping in the shot by turning it green. And it will get rid of everything else. So you see, I've only clicked twice, but it's already found most of what I want to keep in the shot. It's very clever. It's kind of worked out with four clicks, and I possibly overclicked. So it's very, very straightforward. So it's basically on the first frame, it knows exactly what I want to isolate and remove the rest. So now all I need to do is to go to done masking. And now what it's going to do is it's just going to run that mask that I've created on the first frame throughout the whole video. Again, takes a couple of minutes. And it's done it. So now I can just watch a preview just to make sure I'm happy with that. It's not giving me the audio. I don't really need the audio, but I do think that it exports it. And yeah, I'm really happy with that. I didn't need to correct it at all. I have found on slightly more complex videos when there's more movement, I have had to correct the odd frame, but with this one, it's just done it straight away without any additional editing by me. So really happy with that. And then I just simply click on export. And at this point, I want to keep it as 4K because that's the original that I filmed it on. And also I want to export the eventual video to YouTube in 4K. Now, I've paid for the premium package, but you don't have to. I think you can actually get up to 720 or possibly even 1080 for free. But I'm just going to do export video now as an MP4. And it gives me a little message down here. Export submitted. View it in the assets page. So if I go over to assets now, and you can see it's just exporting it here, exporting 0%, and eventually it'll export the whole file, and it'll basically have removed the background and just kept me in it and given me an artificial green screen behind me. So I've got Premiere Pro open, and you'll notice that on the timeline I've got the original intro to camera with no green screen effects or anything. And if I scrub through that timeline, you'll notice there are no explosions right now. Okay, so the next step I'm going to do, if I go to my media browser, is I'm going to bring in the version of me that is exactly the same, except the background's been removed and there's just a green screen behind me that we've artificially created. And I'm just going to put that there for now, because what I'm going to do is remove the sound from the green screen, because there's no need for it to be there. It's just a duplicate of the intro. And I'm going to move the green screen on top of the original. And now all you can see is the green screen layer, because that's on top, it's masking the one that's below that. So if I now go to an effect called Ultra Key, and I lift the ultra key effect onto the green screen timeline. Then I'm going to go to the key color over here on the effect on the left. I'm going to click on the green. So if I make the rotoscope version of me invisible by clicking on the little eye on this layer, you're not going to notice any difference, right? However, if I click the little eye and make the original layer invisible, it's going to get rid of the background, because effectively by using the ultra key on the rotoscoped green screen layer, it's basically removed the green background and all it's got is me, right? And therefore, when it's on top of the original, because it's a duplicate, it looks like exactly the same. But what it does mean is if we just lift the layers up a little bit, we can put anything we like in between these two, and effectively we can put an effect between the background and me. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce an explosion effect that I've got from Envato Elements. I use Envato Elements all the time. It has an amazing library of licensed music, loads of stock video that you can use. And the great thing is, because it's got a license and you get a license to use it, you don't have to worry about YouTube copyright strikes. And what's really cool is it now has an AI function where you can type into the type of project you're working on. Then it'll automatically produce a huge list of different assets that you might want to use in that project. I've even used Envato Elements for a presentation at work because it's got some really cool PowerPoint templates. If you think that you could make use of Envato Elements for your projects, there is a link to Envato in the description below. Let's get back to it. So now I've gone to Envato Elements and I've got my explosion effect. I'm now going to move that onto the timeline between the original intro and the rotoscope version of the intro. And you can see where I've stopped speaking, basically where I want the intro to come in. You can see here, it basically says, that's where I stopped speaking. That's where I want the effect to come in. So let's just listen back so that you can see what I mean there. So if you wanted to create a visual effect, okay, so that's coming in at about the right moment. What you'll notice is the resolution of the camera that I filmed with is actually at 4K, whereas the Envato element effect is actually half that at 1080p. So what I'm going to do is basically double the size of the explosion in terms of scale so that it matches with the frame that I've filmed at. So move that from 100 to 200. And the explosion's now kind of filling the screen. But you'll notice the background of the room has disappeared. So I'm going to use another key effect, and I'm just going to do so by going over to effects here, and I'm going to type in key. But this time, rather than ultra key, I'm going to use color key, and I'm going to lift that and put that onto the explosion effect. Now I'm going to use the pipette, and I'm going to use a sample color as the black. And that will then leave the flames, but introduce the background behind the flames. So you can see that again. So if we just scrub back and see what this is looking like so far. So if you wanted to create a visual effect, like an explosion, how would you make that? So the explosion is coming in at about the right point in time. And now I just want to add a sound effect. So I'll take one that I've got from Envato Elements again. This one is called Mountain Audio Cosmic Explosion Number 2. And I'm just going to make that a little bit quieter because it's quite loud at the moment. Let's just scrub through the timeline and see how loud that is. So that's about right in terms of the volume of the explosion. So let's watch that back so far and see how it's all coming together. So if you wanted to create a visual effect, like an explosion, how would you make that effect appear? Okay, so that's pretty cool. I think just for a bit of fun, let's add some smoke now. And again, I'm using one from Envato Elements called Smoke Explosion 1 2023. Let's just move that onto the timeline. And we're just going to move that towards the end of the effect so that it kind of, just going to move that towards the end of the effect so it comes in sort of once the explosion's already happened. And again, I think we'll need to use a color key. Yeah, because otherwise it just looks all black. So let's use the color key effect again. Move that on top. And we're just going to use the pipette. And that brings back the background and the explosion. Let's have a look and see whether we're just about there in terms of the complete effect.
So if you wanted to create a visual effect, like an explosion, how would you make that effect appear between the subject that's being filmed in a physical space and the background of that physical space?
Okay, so I just feel like the smoke didn't quite time itself very well. So I'm just going to do a little bit of snipping here. I'm going to get rid of the first bit and I'm going to bring the second bit in to occur about the same time. Let's have another look and see whether we finally nailed it.
So if you wanted to create a visual effect, like an explosion, how would you make that effect appear between the subject that's being filmed in a physical space and the background?
Okay, and just one last little detail here. I like the way the smoke is looking, but I just want it to disappear a little bit sooner. So I'm just going to go back and reduce the opacity gradually.
How would you make that effect?
Okay, so I think it peaks about there, and I kind of want it to disappear fairly quickly after that. So at that point in the timeline on the smoke, I'm just going to click on opacity keyframe timer thing, and then we're just going to drag it a few frames on, and I'm just going to make it disappear by that point. Let's do zero there, so there's no more smoke. And let's have one last little look, and I think we should have got it this time.
So if you wanted to create a visual effect, like an explosion, how would you make that effect appear between the subject that's being filmed in a physical space and the background of that physical space?
I think we've got it. So I really hope that this video has been helpful to you. And if it has, why not hit that like button to help you see more content like this and to help my channel to grow on YouTube. And if you really liked it, why not subscribe? Until next time, take care of yourself, and I'll see you in the next one.